Whenever a pet eats and we have carbohydrates, we're gonna have a bunch of sugar that's in the blood, and the insulin therapy is gonna help to take that sugar and put it into our cells where our body needs it to basically function. And dogs and cats that are diabetic, who either have either lack of insulin production or they have insulin that's not working very well, they don't have the ability to get that blood sugar into their cells where they need it. In dogs, we primarily see what we call type 1 diabetes or insulin-dependent diabetes, meaning the pancreas just does not produce enough insulin, and those dogs typically require insulin for the duration of their life. In cats, we see both types, but cats do get a lot of what we call type 2 diabetes, and that has to do with a little bit more with their diet and potential weight, meaning some cats that we diagnose are overweight. And in some cats, we can get them on an appropriate diet, get weight reduction involved, and sometimes those cats no longer require insulin in the future. A lot of owners will ask us the question, you know, once their animal's been diagnosed with diabetes, is what does this mean for them? Are they still gonna have a good quality of life? And the answer is generally yes. Our goal in treating the diabetic animal is to basically have a resolution of those clinical signs. You know, our number one and number two goals for treating an animal that has diabetes is number one, to have a happy animal. Number two, we wanna have a happy owner. And we're gonna do that by controlling the clinical signs. So again, with some diligence of the owner and the diligence of the veterinarian, we can usually accomplish those goals. And their quality of life tends to be very good. It should go back to what it was prior to the diagnosis.